Hey guys, welcome back to a new reaction on this channel. Today I'm going to be reacting to Between the Buried and Me. First, I'm excited because you guys know I already reacted to this band. I reacted to the song Fix the Errors. Was a really cool song. I really liked that one, especially the drum parts with the three different drummers, I guess. Really awesome. It's also in my Spotify playlist. But I'm also a little bit scared because the song is really long. It's 14 minutes. You guys know I'm not the biggest fan of long songs. But I also know that there are a lot of absolute amazing longer songs. For example, Neoblivious Chorus or many songs of Machine Head, for example. So I'm still excited. I'm still excited. The only problem I have, I also have the same with Fix the Errors. Also, I think Fix the Errors is almost too long, and this song is just 5 minutes. It's because after you listen to these 5 minutes, it's a really cool song and stuff, but after the 5 minutes, you also have the feeling, so, oh yes, now I really heard everything of the song. Good that it ends. Let's say it that way. But it's still an absolute good, amazing song. And now a 14-minute song, and if this happens, like in Fix the Errors, after 5 minutes, then it's just 9 minutes, whatever. We will see. But I also read a few articles about that this song could be, or should be, or whatever, the best record ending. I guess it's on the record Colors. I guess it's called Colors. I hope I'm right. Oh yeah, there's Colors. All right. Everything cool. I haven't read that. It's on the record Colors, and it's the last one. So I guess there are just 8 songs on the record, or 9, I guess 8. And this is the last song of the record. And many people are saying that this is the best record ending you can get. So maybe it's... Sorry, I will put my phone away before it will disturb everything. Maybe it's that long because it should be an absolute great ending. So I'm excited. I have to think with an ending of a record also inside of me. All right, cool. Let's go.
We'll be right back.
right, it's time to first pause. I'm really sorry. All right. It's definitely a good song. I was a little bit also a little bit scared because I read the lyrics before I reacted to the song now. Or I can't say that I really read them. Let's just say I saw the lyrics, and the lyrics were really short for a 14-minute song. So I'm a little bit surprised that they are singing that much right now, or screaming, or whatever, because it wasn't really much lyrics for that kind of long song. Holy crap. That's why I thought there is a lot of instrumental in this song, but right now there's not really much instrumental, so of course. But the instrumentals were really, really cool. They got a lot of speed changes. They also did that in Fix the Errors, and I guess it's also because they have these progressive styles and progressive parts in this in the song. But it sounds really cool. In my opinion, I really like the song. I don't know what will come also in the song. So we are just through 5 minutes. Right now, I really hope for a change in the song, because it sounds really cool, but also I got to the feeling, like in Fix the Errors, that I think I heard everything from the song. So maybe, or let's say I hope, they will do a little change also into it, because I like long songs when there are a lot of changes in the song, like it felt 3 or 4 songs in one, and right now we have one song in 5 minutes, so I hope that there are coming changes. Also, I saw this one here. Maybe you guys know that when you have your mouse down on the line, you see what parts are the people are watching the most, and you see this curve here from this to this. This means that a lot of people are just watching or listening, in this case, to this part. You see there's no single upwards going line, whatever. But here at the end, a lot of people are just listening to the end of the song. So I really hope for a freaking explosive thing at the end. I'm honest. I saw that before I recorded that, and I was like, alright, the end has to be an absolute twisting point or whatever. So I'm so excited for the ending, but we are not there. So let's go again. Alright, go.
Thank you.
and I'm sorry to pause, but I really wanted to pause before we get into this part, and we are going directly into it, where the people are listening to the most, let's say it that way. So now I got my instrumental part, but in my opinion, it was a really good instrumental part, because when I say I think it's boring if it's just instrumental, I mean bands, for example, and this is not hate or something, because I also like the band, and for example, Iron Maiden. I like Iron Maiden, I have a lot of songs of them in my playlist, but I also know songs of them which are also going 14 minutes, and then you have this one, yeah, let's say this one riff or this one verse, and they just make that in a loop for 10 minutes or something like that. For example, I don't know how the song is called, The Red and the Blue. Is it called That Way? I can't remember. It's a 13 or 40 minute song, and there's one part of the song where they just loop this riff. They just loop it and loop it and loop it and loop it, and for at least 5, 6, maybe 7 minutes. And I was like, I can't listen to 5, 6, 7 minutes to the same loop all over again. When it's not a game, for example. I mean, if you play Mario, it's the same song in a loop. But this is something different. When I want to listen to music, I want to listen to new stuff, to fast stuff, to whatever stuff, and not listening to the same thing all over again. That's what I wanted to say. So I think Between the Buried and Me did it really, really good in this song, because it wasn't a loop. It was something new every 1 hour, let's say that way, because they had this, I don't want to say choir parts, but this whispering part where you just heard the singer like whispering, like a little bit in the background. Then you got the part where it was like a build up for a breakdown. And then you got the breakdown, and I think this was really, really good. Really, really well made for an instrumental part. And now we are going directly to the part all the people love. I mean, I saw it, I see it here. So I'm really excited. It has to be a really cool twist or something completely whatever. Don't disappoint me now. Let's go. to that. Alright! By the way, the song is called White Walls. I guess I forgot to say that. I know it's too late now, but I don't care. Alright! So the last part was really, really good. I'm honest, it was really good. And I don't want to say I'm disappointed in the last part, because definitely not. I really, really liked the last part, but I expected something different. Because I think the people are liking the last part because of the guitars. The riff and the guitars are so good in the last part. Holy crap. Really amazing. But I expected, because so many people are just listening to the end of the song, that I expected something completely different. Like they are playing at the end, I don't know, a German Schlager song, or for example. Sounds weird, but for example, I expected something completely out of nowhere. It wasn't something out of nowhere, in my opinion, but it was a really, really good part. The only problem I have right now is, I guess, the problem a lot of people have, because this is a really long song, and what the people are liking are the last, don't let me lie, 4 or 5 minutes of the song. And the problem I have now, I would now put the song into my playlist, and I would listen to it, and I just want to listen to the last 4 or 5 minutes. But you have to listen to 9 minutes to come to these 4 or 5 minutes you really want to listen to. And that's also a problem I have with long songs, because long songs are really cool, but if there's just one part that's really good in a long song, then you won't listen to the complete song just for this 2 or 3 minutes you really want to listen to. And that's the case here. So, nothing against the first 9 minutes. The song in general was really good. I really liked the song. But when I listen to the song, I really want to listen to the last 4 or 5 minutes, like a lot of people. I mean, you can see it. And I think that's a little bit of a problem here. That you have to listen to 9 minutes before you come to this part you really want to listen to. So, I don't know if I will put the song into my playlist. Maybe because just for fun, because I also listen something to music just on shuffle and don't skip a song because I don't want to, or I can't, for example, at work, for example, or something, that I just listen to the songs that will come. So then I would listen to the complete 14 minutes. But when I just listen to music for myself in general, when I just want to listen to the songs I like, I would skip the song for a lot of times, I guess, because I don't want to listen to the whole song for the last 4 or 5 minutes. But hey, it's all I say is just my personal opinion. But in general, also for a record ending, so for final song for a record, it's really cool. It's a really good song. I really like that one. If I will put it to my playlist, I will see, maybe for the work, but not for my free time. We will see, I'll let you know. And that's all I can say. Alright? Cool. Alright, but thanks for this request. If you have any other requests, wishes, whatever, write that down in the comments, or you can write me on Instagram. Link is down in the description if you want to talk about Between the Buried and Me. Join our community Discord. Link is down in the description. You can join anytime. You can talk about anything you want. Would be cool to see you there. And then I hope I see you guys again in another reaction. Would be awesome. And I say, bye!